Lo mejor de los Rolling Stones, contado por los Rolling Stones.
For the show, creation, the doubts, last minute changes, exciting, energy, what else?
Argentina's gonna see him. It doesn't matter, he makes one or two mistakes. My latest guitar roadie trick is that they hand me guitars with highly perverted photographs pasted on them.
It's a buzz for them and a buzz for us.
There's a new guy in town, he's been dragging around. He's the figure of youth, and his eyes are so blue, and they're looking at you. So tell me the truth. Well, he's got stories to tell. He bites off more than he chews. Well, is he ringing your bell? My heart is breaking in two.
The receptions where you go everywhere are just amazing.
You can't go wrong with audiences like this.
Ready? Okay, here we go.
Nice to know that people come to see you, you know?
Show is supposed to be a show.
Thank you.
have a really super enthusiastic audience, it makes a more exciting show.
I don't realise the difference. I see the difference. It's like,
when you have an audience that's more, that's seen everything, then you have to work a lot harder. But if you work too hard, it looks ridiculous. So you have to time it right.
These guys, you know, are ready.
Brazil I've been to, so I knew they were very warm.
Look, this is beautiful girls in Brazil.
Compared to the last tour, it's a lot more comfortable, a lot more relaxed.
Time when it's hard, you guys. What was your favourite moment?
Ole, 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 ole.
Where am I? Where am I?
JC, will you be pleased to leave Buenos Aires being the head of security? You found it rather difficult here.
No, it's marvellous here.
Beautiful women. Beautiful women, but what about the actual job?
I've never worked so hard in my life.
That's what I thought. So did you have a nice time in Buenos Aires?
I tell you, Nick, quite honestly, it beat the hell out of Brazil, beat the hell out of Sao Paulo. No, I didn't. It, quite honestly, we really enjoyed it. You
take shows of tension,
melody,
the light,
harmony.
Everyone is enjoying themselves.
It's wonderful.
We just try to do our best.
Started off kind of slow, this one, in a way, and there was quite a lot of negativity at the beginning, so I won't pretend it was that easy. It was pretty difficult at the beginning, but once we got going, it was all right.
This is probably the best Stones tour they've ever done, probably the best Stones band that we've ever had. I know that because Charlie Watts is smiling.
We noticed that we're cutting new ground, you know, in that no bunch of guys have ever stuck together this long in the rock and roll field.
I don't look at the Rolling Stones like that, you know. It just, they're a group of people that I know that become the Rolling Stones when they get together. You know, something happens around us, and it happens when we play, that is either magic or catastrophe, whichever way you look at it. It always has done, and I assume it always will.
We know that.
American section's been really good. Started off in Mexico. And all these countries actually we've never played in. We've all visited them, but we've never played in them. So, you know, it's been pretty exciting. A completely different temperament, as you can imagine.
For the first time playing, you know, Mexico, Buenos Aires, it is definitely voodoo territory.
I mean, I never knew what the attraction was when we played in clubs, you know?
I never really liked to analyze it. I think it's not really my job. My job is to go out there and do it, be it.
That's a good job.
Well, I suppose they're like an old prostitute.
What did you say?
It's a sort of gained a certain respectability over the years and you know, also one that doesn't seem to go away.
So I don't know quite what to say.
For people, for, you know, younger generations born after 1963 or four, you know, you have sun, you have the moon, you have the air they breathe, and you've got the Rolling Stones, you know, I mean, they've just been there all the time, you know, I mean, and I intend to stay.
That is a really good feeling. I mean, it is fantastic, you know, that you could do that. You know, sometimes I get out and people say to me, I lost my virginity when I played Beast of Burden, and you go, wow, that's great, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you got laid by it, yeah.
So I sometimes think of that when we go out and play the song, you know. That is really, it makes me feel really good.
But coming to think about it, it feels great.
I've never taken this life seriously anyway. I'm very grateful to it. It's a great ego thing. But you couldn't believe it, could you?
Backstage. Unless we have permission.
Six and seven. 79. Saying that, baby, I'm the lone crap shooter.
Yeah, it's you know, you try and reserve a certain amount of time per night to do certain things to get it, really it gets you in the mood for the show, really. I mean, it's very useful to do all these things, warm up before, you know, changing into the clothes and so on, gets you more into the mood of the show, so out of the personality of the other personality and gets you into the show mood.
So I go out with about 15 different guitars. I have affairs with all of them.
I hate them, but they love me. And, you know, when you... You know, what can I say? Hey, give it a kiss. You know, I think it's the shape. You know, they made me love them. But they beat me up something bad, you know. I mean, they got hands like a boxer now from playing that thing, you know. Sometimes we just do a couple of minutes and right, that's okay. And other times we pull it through longer until we feel satisfied that we're okay.
For the show,
apprehension,
doubts,
last minute changes,
my explosives,
exciting,
energy,
what else?
Different every night.
Magic.
Still the same tension.
150%.
You really have to concentrate on what you're doing. You just cannot drift. You get these crazy temptations to drift off, you know. But before the show, you know, just the moment before, you have to really concentrate.
Open the cage, let the tigers out.
Comes the minute the show starts, the minute the first, you know, intro goes in. They're thinking of harmony, melody, and timing, you know, how to stay in touch.
A lot of the time the people are talking to you, they're going, yeah, you know, and I'm going, I've got to remember the next change, you know. And it's really funny.
For me, you know, once I sit down to play, I don't think about that until I stand up finished at the end.
After the first few shows, you know, after playing Got Me Rocking, you know, Love Is Strong, Sparks Will Fly, how is it? It's like they've been there forever.
was pretty tough, Mexico, because it was so high up. And every time I couldn't even sing, let alone move around. I'd sing the first line great, second line great, third line, I start to run out of breath, fourth line, there was no line. And trying to move as well was like, I was like,
exist is what it get a poison kiss.
Oh, it's very good chemistry.
Charlie and Daryl have really locked in. I needed a new engine down in the engine room, you know what I mean? Reciprocating engines, you know? That's what we got.
They trust me to do my job. There's no one really hanging over my head to say, okay, play this way or do this or do that.
Fantastic. Words are not needed.
We've just known each other so long, I don't know, really.
I describe it like this, very explosive, could explode at any minute.
We play a lot like that.
The risk is the kick.
Particularly with Keith, you do.
Angels told me. There's a lot of talent.
All the great people we have with us, like Bernard Fowler and Lisa Fisher and Chuck Lavelle and Bobby Keys, they're great guys.
Here are our present our banda. Primero a la mesa, Lisa Fisher.
I'm going on tour with the Rolling Stones.
The great muscle, Bernard Fowler.
Feel is perfection.
On the piano, Chuck. Look,
even though it is a spectacle, the most important thing is the music.
The saxophone, Mr. Bobby Keys.
What is the magic? Magic is rock and roll.
The bass, Mr. Daryl Jones.
The way the music, the way it grooves.
I can't explain it. I just dig it.
The worst thing is a musician talking about music.
Roots.
You need poets for that.
Basically. We still never forget Muddy Waters.
Chuck Berry.
Duke Ellington.
Little Richard.
Soul and R&B.
Good rock and roll.
With Miles Davis.
Did Elvis Presley, Buddy Holly.
Lester Young.
They turned us on.
Oh, yeah.
I think a band like the Rolling Stones is good things about it, that it's got a good tradition and so on, and then it's very based in these very long roots. And the criticism of it is that, given that though, the Rolling Stones will tend to repeat itself too much, and so you have to try and find the line where it's innovative enough but not slavish to fashion, but yet true to its roots, yet not boring and repetitive. So it's kind of like really a fine line, I find.
I thought it was one of the best records we've made for a long time. So by the time I was into it and finishing it, I said, well, if this don't fly, then I crash.
Los Rolling Stones, desde adentro. Estuvimos en Amsterdam. En el comienzo de su gira europea, en los ensayos y en las dos presentaciones del grupo en Le Paradiso, un conocido bar del lugar con capacidad para 800 personas, al que accedimos unos pocos privilegiados.
bracing day it is today. I like sailing.
Hi there, how are you, right?
Noches en vivo, un show semiacústico, que luego de su selección y mezcla final, formará parte de su nuevo disco en vivo.
Saying goodbye, but it's always a pleasure to say hello.
Person who can come on here is Madonna.
Is there anything else to talk about, you mean?
South America.
I don't really speak Spanish.
Especially Buenos Aires. And these guys, you know, are ready.